I'm going to go to the next one. I have all the parts already unlocked. I just now put a target line up because Which is probably the easiest part of the mission. But there we are. backwards along the Moon's orbit, and then we exit
this
the
mission
Moon, the
of the so-called
so
blunder. It's
orbits,
not really a
the Moon,
proper blunderbird, so I didn't bother
kind
with the whole
yellow dot
on a lonely planet.
Intro,
but you know, I hope you enjoyed it nonetheless. Around
next
Kerbin,
week,
if I don't come up with anything better, it will be
not what we want.
It's
not the end of the world.
Making of the
ultimate
SSTO
kind of decircularized.
So yeah, there are links on screen to other things, and like I said, I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy the rest of the weekend.
Kind of synonymous, but it's kind of a weird choice of words. Anyway. I'm getting off topic here. So we can actually, as you can see, get our periapsis to be within Kerbin's atmosphere directly from the Moon without having to do a secondary burn when we're around Kerbin. So I guess, I hope you kind of understood what you were supposed to do just from watching. Look at that. Beautiful Kerbin rise, by the way. I hope you kind of understood what to do just from watching that. Create a Manuma node that's sort of around the other side of the Moon from where you want to be exiting from. Does that make sense? I hope that made sense. Just dragging out the prograde marker to raise your apoapsis. Okay, you guys definitely get this. Okay, I don't need to detail it so you know, thoroughly. But when you're at your Manuma node, just throttle up, I guess. If you want to make things faster, I probably shouldn't mention this earlier, but I get a lot of people ask me. A surprising number of people ask me, so I'm guessing it's not hugely well known. I mean, I think it's well known, but I guess there is always a percentage of the player base that doesn't know. You can time warp through burns or when you're very close to the surface of celestial bodies by holding down Alt and then pressing the time warp button. So obviously time warp is initiated by pressing the full stop or period button for my American viewers, or the comma to kind of slow down time acceleration. You can hold down Alt and time accelerate through burns and things as well, but you are limited to times 4, which is fine for most people. Moho missions can be pretty painful doing this way, or Ion engines or Ghillie missions as well. So you can get the mod Better Time Warp to let you kind of have even faster time warp rates through physics, although that can be sometimes a little bit glitchy, which is why the stock game doesn't do it. And then when we're ready to detach our lower stage, if you want to do this like echo it properly, kind of point normally, as in sort of to the pink triangles, so normal or anti-normal, that just ensures that your stage doesn't directly, like, doesn't fall directly below you and you won't end up crashing into any exploding debris. Not that I don't think it really matters in this game, because I always, in videos, I generally detach directly retrograde just because it looks cooler from a video standpoint. But I guess if you want to do this kind of sensibly, you would detach it normally and anti-normally. Now, this is the one part of the mission where we didn't do things particularly faithful to Apollo, because we're not going to be landing in the sea. But I don't really mind. I think it's fine. We did have 3 parachutes though, so that's pretty neat, don't you think? But no, that pretty much wraps the video up, to be honest. I hope you enjoyed. Do you guys want more tutorials? I feel like I quite like giving them, but I also am worried that it is kind of seen as this, oh, you're just kind of milking. I don't know why. Maybe I'm just more cynical than most, but if people want more tutorials, I can totally do them. You'll have to let me know in the comments what you feel is lacking in the world of tutorials, because I feel like most subjects are covered by other people. But yeah, I don't know, if there's anything that you feel is lacking, or you want something, like, you want me to cover it, then by all means, do let me know in the comments, and I do read comments. People think that I don't read comments for some reason, but I do. I read all the comments, so yeah, I don't always read ones that are flagged as spam, because most are just spammy, and YouTube has this thing where sometimes it thinks you're a spam commenter, even though some of them, I've looked through them, they're not spam at all. So if I don't react to your comment or like reply, it might be because it was flagged as spam for some reason. But we are getting a little bit off topic somewhat, but there we go, touchdown. So once you've done that, make sure you recover the module. Obviously, I don't know why you would forget to do that, but just in case. And then on screen, we have some more things, namely the tutorials playlist. I've got a playlist of all the tutorials I've done. I've also got a playlist of Blunderbird's missions, because they're kind of like soft tutorials, I guess, so they're kind of the same sort of subject. Bottom left is just my most recent upload, and bottom right was specially selected by YouTube's algorithm just for you. So other than that, Patreon, Discord, Twitter are all in the description, and have a good day. And Christmas! It's good Christmas soon.